Open your EVIEWS and import your data file for which you want to run the regression analysis. Okay, so as you can see, these all are the variables in my data set. There are total 200 observations from time period 2000 to 2019. Okay, now you need to select all those variables for which you want to run the ordinary least square method. Okay, so first select your dependent variable followed by all the independent variables. Okay, and then open these as equation. Okay, so you can see here the first one is the dependent variable. GDB is the dependent variable in my data set. Then there are four independent variables. So one is life expectancy, then literacy rate, unemployment, and fertility rate. Okay, so this is about the variables. Then you need to put a C for the constant over here. Okay, you can also put this constant after the dependent variable. Okay, you can keep it after the dependent variable, or you can keep it at the end of the equation also. So that doesn't matter. All right, now to run a simple OLS regression, you can see over here in the methods section, numerous methods are available for running regression analysis. Okay, but we need what we wanted here is to run a OLS regression. So click on this least square method. Okay, and the sample is from 2000 to 2019. Okay, now click OK. So you can see here the results for the OLS regression. Okay, it shows panel least squares because the data was a panel data set, and these are all the variables. So see, here is for the constant, first variable independent life expectancy, second independent variable is literacy rate, third one is unemployment, and fourth one is fertility rate. All right, then these are the coefficients or regression coefficients or elasticities that were estimated using the OLS method. These are the standard errors, t statistic value, and the probability value. Moreover, you can look at the R square value, which is 76%, and the adjusted R square is 0.755. All right, then you can have a look at the F statistics probability, which is 0.000. So how do we interpret the results of a OLS regression, OLS method? See, as you can see, while reporting your results, you need to have a look at the probability value, and you need to have a look at the R square value and F statistic value. So if the probability value is greater than 5% level of significance, that is, if it is greater than 0.05, then that variable is insignificant. Okay, so you can see here all the independent variables, be it life expectancy, literacy rate, unemployment, or fertility rate, the probability value for all these independent variables is less than 0.05, that is 5% level of significance. So this indicates that all these variables significantly affect the dependent variable. Okay, and how do we interpret the regression coefficients value? So have a look at the first one. Suppose the regression coefficient value is 4.62. Okay, so this means that a 1% increase in the life expectancy rate, GDP will increase by 4.62% or units. Okay, similarly, you can interpret rest of the regression coefficients. Let's have a look at the regression coefficient of another variable, which is fertility rate. So if there is a 1% increase in fertility rate, GDP will reduce by 2.23% because there is a negative sign for this particular regression coefficient corresponding to fertility rate. All right, so in this manner, you can interpret your regression coefficients and you can also determine whether a particular independent variable is significant in the model or it is not significant. All right, then you can have a look at the R square value, which is 0.76. So it is quite good, which indicates the fit of the data, that is 76% of the variation in the dependent variable is being caused by all these independent variables. And the last one is the probability of F statistics, which is 0.000. So it indicates the robustness of the entire regression model. So this value is also less than 5% level of significance. So in total, we can conclude that four of the variables were significant. R square value and F statistics are also supporting the results. So this is how you can run a simple ordinary least squared method for a panel data set, and this is how you can interpret your results and report your results accordingly for your particular data set. So thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, please click on the subscribe button so that you get a notification and you can catch up with the upcoming videos. Thank you very much.